Hello everybody, this is Dr. G.P. Sudhakar, Professor of Management from India. Right, in this specific video, I am going to explain you what is the difference between theory X and theory Y. Right, both the theories come under motivational theories in an organizational environment. Right, theory X and theory Y are proposed by Douglas McGregor way back in 1960s. Right, according to, you know, both the theories, they expect distinct behaviors from the attitudes from the employees. Right? For example, theory X, it assumes negative attitude and negative behavior from the employees, whereas theory Y assumes positive attitude, positive behavior from the employees. Right? See, basically, a manager predicts certain behavior from the employees. Based on his assumptions, he tries to mold the performance of an employee in meeting organizational objective. Manager, according to his thinking, how he considers a team member, record based on that, you know, he tries to, you know, mold the attitude and behavior of team member in meeting organizational objective. Right, organizational objective, right? So according to theory X, basically theory X, it considers a negative attitude and negative behavior. That means it assumes employee, he won't take initiative on his own. Employees are not ready to take responsibility. Employee, he is not self-motivated. He won't take the responsibility. He tries to avoid the work. At the time, employee tries to avoid the work. Like that, theory X assumes. Theory X assumes. And also, the manager who is following theory X, he thinks that an employee has to be coerced or to be punished to get the needed performance from the employee. Needed performance from the employee. That is about theory X manager. And also, theory X manager thinks that an employee is, you know, all the time he wants only job security, but he is not committing to the organizational tasks. Like that, theory X manager thinks, right? Now, come back to theory Y. See, theory Y is, you know, it expects a positive attitude and positive behaviors from the employees, right? So, theory Y, it considers, you know, it says that, the employee is self-motivated, he is self-regulated, self-controlled, he takes initiative in meeting organizational tasks, right? Employee is, he does the organizational work as a regular play, or regular, you know, his regular job, he is tries to take the employee organizational tasks, right? An employee takes responsibility. He won't avoid the tasks. He takes the responsibility. He is committed. And also, you know, theory Y, it considers that, you know, an employee is not only there for job security purposes, he is also committed to the organizational tasks. He is also committed to the organizational tasks. He is self-regulated, self-motivated, and self-controlled. Self-controlled, that's what theory Y assumes from the employee, right? So the manager who is following theory Y, he thinks that employee is self-motivated, he does work on his own, he's, you know, he's ready to take responsibility, you know, he wants to contribute to the team. Like that, manager considering theory Y will assume from his employee. So based on these two theories, a manager tries to, you know, think about an employee, and he tries to mold the employee behavior, attitude towards in achieving the needed performance from the employee or in meeting organizational objectives. The manager molds his team member in meeting organizational objectives, right? So these two theories are proposed by Douglas McGregor, related to motivational theories inside an organizational environment. Right. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.